Alright, welcome back everybody. Today we're working on the 740 ignition. I had a problem, I think I made it a little short about it, where every time I turned ignition on, the number one fuse would blow. And then, obviously it got me like digging and diagnosing and all that. So what the problem ended up being was the ignition switch. It was shorting the switch itself. So, first of all, number one fuse controls the main fuel pump, which is this one, which goes right there under this driver. Don't mind all that. And the ECU. I was really hoping it wasn't an ECU issue, and I figured it wasn't because these cars don't really have that kind of problem. However, this guy, if you don't know what this guy is, this is the fuel pump relay. They have a big issue with that. I'll put some pictures up, but so to find out if it's to kind of diagnose a little further, or let me tell you what was actually happening. What was actually happening is I was driving on the highway and I saw the fuse blow and the car cut out, and I was like, what the hell? Kind of weird. And I pulled over and I'm turning the ignition on, and the moment I turned the ignition on, the fuse blows again. I had replaced it, obviously, the infamous 25 amp. So I'm like, what the hell, you know, it's kind of weird. And I'm like fiddling around with the wiring and stuff, and I did it again, and that time the fuse doesn't blow, but the fuel pump didn't prime either. So I was like, okay, kind of weird. And the thing is, relays don't blow fuses. It's not really a common thing. So I kind of already started having an idea that it wasn't the relay, because, I mean, the moment you turned the ignition on, it wouldn't even get to energize and the fuse would blow, which is kind of weird. And so I jumped the relay. I'll put a diagram on which pins you have to jump. I think it's 30 and 87, if I'm not remembering wrong. And I heard the fuel pump prime. The fuse didn't blow. So the fuse didn't blow. The fuel pump primed. But the ignition was not on. Remember, ignition was not on, because you're essentially hot wiring to battery. And so that already took the fuel pump out of the equation. And then when I was jumping the relay, I turned the ignition on and the fuse blew. And I was like, all right, most likely it's gonna be an ignition thing. So I took the ignition apart, at least like the connector, and then I popped off the tab and everything, phew, blew up here, of course. And then at this point, they're all running the same circuit, so people might say it's not safe to touch each things to each other, but guys, it runs on the same circuit. If you've ever seen one of these switches, the ignition switches, they all run on the same circuit. So I started touching cables together to figure out, obviously black's your ground. Both of the reds are power. So if I touch this, you can hear a relay activate. If I'm not wrong, those are the windows. Either windows or the lights, either one. And then this one doesn't even make a noise. Okay, so this is the windows. Color is windows, non-color, they're both blue and yellow, is the lights. And then I touch the red and blue, which this is like the main power source that goes to the fuse. You touch this, the whole car energizes. And this pink is the starter. I'm not gonna touch it because I don't wanna start the car right now. But, and then the yellow and the white is seatbelt reminder, if I'm not wrong, which I already don't have seatbelts, so not even gonna connect that. I'm gonna cut that up actually. And then I have these bullet connectors set, so I made a little harness to touch everything to see if the car started, and everything started. Fuse didn't blow, so we confirmed that it was a ignition issue. I have a multimeter. If you're confused on what's ground and what's power at any point in your life and you have a multimeter, use it. See, here we have our reading. If I touch red, one of the reds, because they're both power, and then I'm touching the black. There you go. Black is your ground. If you touch any other lead, like I'm touching blue and yellow right now, it's still going to read the same thing, because essentially it is a ground, because it's like pre-load, you know, right before the load, it's a ground, or right before the load. Well, yeah, because your load and then cable, load, cable. So if there's no power attached there, it's going to be the ground. You get the idea. Let me turn this down. All right. So now I told you guys I'd show you how to wire this. Don't mind the tape and this. I'm going to be painting it. I'm just doing the wiring portion right now. You have the relay. There's a wiring diagram on Amazon from the link I bought it from. This was on the right side. I had to switch it to the left side. It's supposed to be on the left side. I don't know why mine came like that. I'll put the diagram up in case you guys want to buy these. This is $20, I think it was like that. Something like that. Something cheap. So, very easy wiring. My phone ran out of storage, so I had to... My bad for the cutout. But, yeah, I was saying the wiring is very easy. My fat ass leg. Wiring is very easy. Obviously, so you got master power coming here, ignition, and then this. So yeah, you got basically these two reds. I'm gonna splice them into one wire, and it's gonna go here. This is going to be the main power source. These are, by the way, 30 amp switches. Make sure to get at least 30 amps, because the highest current flow you're going to have is, well, fuse wise at least, is going to be 25. Well, this is 30, but whatever 16 is, I don't remember. It shouldn't blow, at least not from that. But you want these as a fail-safe switch. So since like these are bigger, I'm sorry, I'm like trying to focus on three things right now. Okay, I'm back. So since these are 25 amps and like 15, 10, blah blah blah, whatever, this 30 shouldn't be a problem. I have to see what 16. Oh wait, I have the chart here. 16 is climate control. I don't even have that, so yeah, I'm not worried. I can even take that out. There we go. But yeah, you have 25, you have 15, 10, whatever it is. So basically, these are 30 amp switches. What happens is the amps will still flow and it will still blow a fuse. If you get something that's 25 amperage switch, or like a 20 or something, that switch is going to blow faster than anything. And then you're going to be like, what the hell is going on? Unless you have a multimeter, obviously, and it's going to be inconvenient. You want a fuse to blow always, not a switch, you know, if that makes sense. Anyways, basically a power comes here, and then this goes to battery ground. Chassis ground might work, and this is for the light in the middle of the knob, that little light. And we're gonna attach the loads here, and that's literally it. One of the reds I'll probably attach to the relay. The other one to the power. This is obviously ground. Attach it to the black. And then this blue one, I believe, goes to this pink for the starter, since it's a starter button. I don't know yet. I might take this whole thing off because I kind of like where my starter button is. I got the D&D horn as the starter button. It's kind of funny. And put like a cigarette lighter in the middle or something. I don't know. I haven't figured that yet. But I'm going to show you how to wire it. I did this wiring already. If you don't know how to wire, I think I do some wiring in the speedometer fix. If not, I'll take a little clip of me wiring these. so you have an idea and you can see exactly where everything goes. And then we'll start flicking switches, and then you guys will see what works, what doesn't, or I mean, you'll see everything should work. So tools needed, I really suggest you get one of these bad boys. This is Blue Point. I mean, I'm a dealer tech, so you know I like having stuff like this. You can get them at Home Depot, Harbor Freight for cheap. You don't really need anything crazy. Multimeter, always recommend it. And so I got these. I'll put the link down. This is male and female connectors. Oh, this just came off. Average China product, whatever. I'll put the link. And then I got these bullet connectors. Since a lot of these Volvos come with the bullet connectors, you know, the bullet connectors and stuff, bunch of relays and stuff, I was just diagnosing. I made the diagnosing sound simple, but I was on it. I didn't want to jump ship on anything, so I was on it for a day or two, at least after work. So, yeah, let me get the wiring started, and then we'll fire this thing up. Welcome back, everybody. It's been a few days since I recorded the last video on the ignition problem. I was in the middle of wiring the new panel. I want to show you guys. It's a shit show. It's an organized shit show, but it is a shit show. So let me see if I can get back here somewhat. Okay, so this should give you a rough idea. Basically, it's very simple. I'm gonna put the wiring diagram up, but we have power coming in here, and then it goes into the block right there. There's like a distribution block that distributes power throughout different sources, starter as well. And then all of these is one splice, because this is power that goes back to the distribution box. Again, you'll see it in the wiring diagram. This brown wire, don't worry about that. That's for the charger. I had messed up the wiring, so I just kind of did like a quick shitty repair. So as you see, these are the ones. So these are, I made connectors. These go straight into the wires that were originally going into the ignition. You'll know what I'm talking about, the pink and the blue and the yellow and all that. So I kind of just took the AC vent out and just put that in there. Look at that. So as you see, I mean, you can't really see. I try to tuck as much as I can. There's a relay for the starter and all that. But there is obviously no more key ignition or anything. However, for the ignition like this, the lock for the steering, you will need a key. Plus, you'll need one for the doors anyway, so it's a good thing to have. It's a good thing to have, because if anybody tries to steal your car, not that anybody's gonna want to try to steal this piece of shit. And if you do, please don't. The steering wheel will lock up, you know, and if they don't have the handy tools, they're not gonna be able to break that lock. Breaking the lock is not very hard. I can't tell you how to do it, and I won't tell you how to do it, but it's not hard. Anyways, basically, obviously we have the main power. As you see, lights up, controls the lights. I think these are looking nice. If you're like this, you know, don't mind that. I mean, we're gonna fix the gaps and stuff eventually. It says main power to the fuse box. And then this is windows. I had three switches. I didn't know what to put there, so I just kind of did all three of them scatter randomly. And then of course you're just, and then we're on. Yeah, everything's good. And then obviously windows, main power, lights, and then you can just turn this off. I mean, you know, it doesn't matter, but I guess for the more dramatic sense, I like that more. But yeah, it's very, very easy. Very easy. So what I did is I had one of the relay power, which is the red, is going to one of the reds, and then the main power is going to the other reds. Obviously, you're gonna have to get one of the reds into here, because the circuit, again, you'll see in the wire diagram, but it's all connected. So it goes here, and this is what's gonna enable the main power to go into the distribution box, and from the distribution box to starter and all of these. And then literally on the other side, it's the load. Very easy. I'm about the shitty LEDs. It was kind of quick. I'm gonna be fixing it when I take the dash out. We're gonna take the dash out due to the evaporator. So if you're interested in that, I'd appreciate a like and a subscribe. But it's a little bootleg. I mean, it does the job, it's pretty sturdy. But yeah, it's a little project. Took me a few days with work and all that. You know, I can't put all my time into this, but I love the way it turned out. I absolutely love the ignition panel. It's honestly great. It's I don't know. It's going to be, in quotation marks, a race car. Not a fast one, obviously, but it's going to be a nice little drift car, you know, a grassroots drift car. It's gutted in the back and all that. Yeah. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, subscribe, share. The support means a lot. If you have any questions, you can reach me on Instagram. These are, I don't know if I mentioned it, 30 amp switches. You want the switches to be higher than that regular amperage on the fuse box, which the highest we have is 30, but it's for the AC, and it's not connected anyways. So, and fuse number 8, that might be AC. I'm not sure what it is. I thought I disconnected the AC. But yeah, see you guys in the next video. Thank you.